Carlton royalty in the house in the form of the skipper, Marc Murphy, Bill, and this man we love and been a member of the family now for a long time. Hello, Murph.
Hey, JB.
Now, what have you been up to? Are you one of the rare footballers that hasn't gone anywhere yet?
Yeah, I am one of the rare footballers that hasn't gone anywhere yet, but off to Bali on Monday. So, looking forward to getting out of Melbourne.
He might see you over there, Jimmy
cross
boy.
Cross over with him.
Yes. Mm. Hey, how have you seen the year personally and yourselves? Because I thought it was a good effort for a side that didn't make the eight to actually, or did make the finals to actually win a final. That's not a bad effort.
Yeah, it was a probably pretty good finish in the end. Obviously, the first time in history that a team hasn't made the eight and snuck in there at ninth. But it was a good game against the Tigers and in front of 96,000, whatever it was. It was great to get over those boys. Then a little bit disappointing against Sydney the following week, but. Yeah, hopefully we can improve on that next year.
And personally, with the captaincy, how do you find it all, mate? Because I assume it's a lot tougher than we all think. We see you run out there and toss the coin.
Yep.
How did you go with it?
I enjoyed the role. Definitely learning on the job this year, but pretty confident going into next year. It's probably a bit of a roller coaster year for myself with trying to manage the knee, which I got sorted out last week. So trying to strengthen it up, and obviously the face as well. But the face is all good now after the fractured cheekbone. But
and the disgraceful helmet that you wore, which we think's probably going to stay with you forever, yeah. Murph. Did you think about that before you pulled it on? Did you think, you know what, I'm going to have to cop this now for the next 20 years. Maybe I'll just miss another one.
Like Jason Dunstan.
That's it.
Yeah, I spoke to you boys up in Sydney before the Sydney game and. Yeah, unfortunately found a helmet which tried to protect the cheekbone, but it looked absolutely disgraceful. Tried to find another one the following week, and that was probably worse.
Yep.
So, the third week, dropped the helmet, but definitely a bit of a laugh. The boys still give me a bit of cover about
that. That's great about footy clubs. Hey, what about as being captain, and say Carlton are looking at Paul Chapman. Do they come to you and say, hey, Murph, what do you reckon? Would you love Chappie playing alongside you?
Yeah, I caught up with Mick last week and talked about a few blokes. But he'd be definitely interested in having the big fella. But obviously, a three-time premiership player, and I think he kicked four goals in his last final, so still a pretty handy player. But not sure what's happening there from last week. But good to get Daisy across.
I'm about to say, we are sure about Dale Thomas, that will add some beautiful run and ball use to the Blues, who have already got plenty of that.
Yeah, he'll add a bit, so hopefully he can get his body right, Daisy. I'll catch up with him on Saturday. I think we're both going to the races together, so that'll be good. So hopefully
we're
in quality
then.
But catch up with Daisy. Good mates with Daisy. Got the same manager, so known Daisy for quite a while. So he'll be a great acquisition for the club.
Yeah, you get the quaddy together and then you're bonded for life.
No,
if you can get the quaddy and it pays 50 or 60 grand, which it might Saturday, and then you are just mates, let me tell you. Unfortunately, on the other side of the coin is a bloke like Eddie Betts, who you would love and played a lot of footy with, and he leaves the club. So it is a difficult time.
Yeah, it is. Obviously, with a free agency and blokes getting offered more money to go elsewhere, It's probably a tough choice for a lot of blokes. Eddie's the club's been great for Eddie, and Eddie's been great for the club. So I was disappointed to lose Eddie, but obviously he got offered a bit too much more cash at the Crows. But we wish him all the best, but not against us.
No.
All right, Murph, we're going to hang on to you for a bit because there's other stuff we need to talk about with this man. Owns a horse himself.
Oh yeah, and it's 1-2 from four, and he tells us he knows he's going to win the Caulfield Cup.
All right, well that might come up next with the skipper of the Blues, Marc Murphy. Thank you, Big Hig. We have got Marc Murphy in here, a Carlton royalty, as we said. And before we get to some exciting stuff, let's talk McDonald's MacPack. You're an ambassador, Murph.
Yeah, ambassador for MacPack, so heading out to Epping today, so all the kids get down there and have a few cheeseburgers and maybe a signature or a photo or two, but heading down there.
It's all about getting kids involved in footy and junior sport and that being active, yeah?
Yeah, it is. It's great. So McDonald's have got a healthy option for the young kids now these days as well, so about getting active and having a healthy lifestyle.
Just not footy, Jim. It's all junior sport,
as you said.
So that, which we like about that. So you're at the Epping store today, 4 to 5.30.
Yep.
Do you know where Epping is?
Yeah, it's a great part of town, Bill. So,
are you out that way, eh?
No, I'm in Port Melbourne, but looking forward to the drive out there.
So do you know where it is?
I do. I'll just punch that in the GPS.
Hey, Murph, a couple of things I want to discuss with you. Firstly, as a very, very good junior cricketer, you reached the fork in the road where you had to make a decision one way or the other. You're actually, I didn't realise this until you told me off air, you were in the AIS as a cricketer, yeah?
Yeah, under 16s. After the under 17s carnival, was in there with the big fella Aaron Finch. So it's good to see the big fella Finchie going well and smashing a few. But I was probably more leaning towards cricket at that point, and then started to play right at footy, and then footy came along. And
so what changed? Was it because, as I often say, Murph, an incredibly difficult sport to be good at, cricket? So did you realise that and think, you know, I might go down the footy path?
Yeah, it's a very tough sport, and obviously football probably comes along a little bit earlier than cricket. Sort of, you're young as a cricketer at 26, 27, whereas in footy you're probably getting a bit on. So, footy came around a little bit earlier, and I was starting to play all right. So,
I think you made a reasonable decision. Yeah, I'll be brutally honest, Murph. What did you do though? Bat, bowl?
Would have batted. You can't.
I was a bat and a little medium pacer. So,
would have bowled little tiny
bit like
medium.
You, Bill.
Outside, you're just tonking through the offside all day.
Yeah.
And you batted a keeper because you got the statue.
No, I was a slipper, not a keeper, Yeah, bowled a little bit of medium pace, like the bowlologist, so a few outswingers, so Damien Fleming, one of the greats.
That's something they don't bowl anymore, and he swing. That's what I've got. I'm trying to get Oscar to do.
Not enough.
You only have to swing it a little bit.
Sit the seam up, Bill. Yeah. Take it away from the bat, and you'll get people out.
And then I used to do that, and drag one back about the fifth.
Is that what you did, Bill?
Fourth or fifth
ball, and mate, out like Terry Alderman. Get out, you sucked in. Hey, I got him.
Let's talk. I need to get Bill off this bloody topic because he'll never stop. Tell us about Charles in charge.
Charles in charge. It was two from two. Unfortunately, two from four. So just put it out to the paddock for a little bit. I think we're bringing it back in a couple of weeks. So hopefully it can run a little bit better than its last couple of performances.
Ooh. Who are you in with and who trains Charles in charge?
Anthony Friedman trains Charles in charge, and in it with a mate and also one of my sponsors down at the club. So Benny Wilson got me involved with that one. So, hopefully he can make it three from five.
What about the $2.5 million Jim Caulfield Cup this weekend, this Saturday, of course. What do you like? Because you'll be going out there with Daisy and won't you be parading around out? Imagine those two out there. Big blue. Does Mick go out too, old Cranky?
No, I'm not sure whether Mick will be heading out there or not. But, me and Daisy will be out there.
Daisy and I,
that's probably a bit better, isn't it, Bill?
David Murph, please. Don't take like elocution lessons from Bill Cross.
Yes, what do you like?
I like Faulkner. I think Drew not a bad barrier from, what did we get? Maybe barrier 12, I think, from
good one.
Faulkner. Barrier draw this morning, so I was watching that.
Yeah, Nicholas Hall on board there, very good. Son of Greg. Imagine that, growing up with Greg Hall as your old man, Jill.
That's it. The doll, any sign of her at the races, or do you fly solo, Murph?
No, she'll be floating around this weekend. So,
and Bali as well?
And Bali. We've managed to get a few boys over there with their partners as well.
Right.
So team up over there.
You haven't convinced her that some me time's necessary post-season, Murph?
I think Derby Day is a bit of me time.
Oh, so, I see.
back in time for that one.
You know what happens there? Derby Day for the boys, and then you say, you go to Oaks Day.
Yeah, you have that.
Correct.
Have that one.
Correct.
And then you finish up with Emirates.
So is that what it is, Bill?
You get two, Murph. That's how it works.
Yeah, exactly right.
Well, you're a star, Murph. Good luck with everything. A big pre-season. Lots of sizzle about the Blues.
Yes.
Adding lots of great talent onto an, as I said, already impressive list. Mick, a second year, Bill, and he's an unbelievably good coach.
Yep.
So good money starting to already lob the Blues way. Great to see you, Murph. Have a great off-season.
Thanks, boys. Cheers.